Hello students, welcome to the third part of our BMAT chemistry revision, titled Chemical Reactions, Formulae, and Equations. As always, here are the learning objectives which are very important to follow, therefore make sure to either pause the video, or make sure you have met them at the end of the video. Let us delve right into it. In ordinary chemical reactions, the nucleus of each atom, and thus the identity of the element, remains unchanged. Electrons, however, can be added to atoms by transfer from other atoms, lost by transfer to other atoms, or shared with other atoms. The transfer and sharing of electrons among atoms govern the chemistry of the elements. During the formation of some compounds, atoms gain or lose electrons and form electrically charged particles called ions. Here is an example. An anion found in some compounds used as antiperspirants contains 13 protons and 10 electrons. What is its symbol? The solution is, because the number of protons remains unchanged, when an atom forms an ion, the atomic number of the element must be 13. Knowing this lets us use the periodic table to identify the element as Al, aluminium. The aluminium atom has lost 3 electrons, and thus has 3 more positive charges, 13, than it has electrons, 10. This is the aluminium cation, Al3+. Ionic compounds. The compound that contains ions, and is held together by ionic bonds, is called an ionic compound. The periodic table can help us recognize many of the compounds that are ionic. When a metal is combined with one or more nonmetals, the compound is usually ionic. This guideline works well for predicting ionic compound formation for most of the compounds typically encountered in an introductory chemistry course. However, it is not always true. For example, aluminum chloride is not ionic. Predicting the formula of an ionic compound. The gemstone sapphire is mostly a compound of aluminum and oxygen that contains aluminum cations, Al3+, and oxygen anions, O2-. What is the formula of this compound? Solution. Because the ionic compound must be electrically neutral, it must have the same number of positive and negative charges. Two aluminum ions, each with a charge of 3+, would give us 6 positive charges, and 3 oxide ions, each with a charge of 2-, would give us 6 negative charges. The formula would be Al2O3. Many compounds do not contain ions, but instead consist solely of discrete, neutral molecules. These molecular compounds, covalent compounds, result when atoms share, rather than transfer, gain or lose, electrons. The bonding characteristics of inorganic molecular compounds are different from ionic compounds, and they are named using a different system as well. The charges of cations and anions dictate their ratios in ionic compounds, so specifying the names of the ions provides sufficient information to determine chemical formulas. However, because covalent bonding allows for significant variation in the combination ratios of the atoms in a molecule, the names for molecular compounds must explicitly identify these ratios. Here are lists of some ionic compounds that you should be familiar with. Make sure to pause the video and have a read through them. On this slide are some examples of some covalent compounds. Make sure to pause and do the same. Now let's continue with writing and balancing chemical equations. Pay close attention as this section can be challenging for some. Substances undergoing a chemical or physical change can be represented using a balanced chemical equation. Consider as an example the reaction between one methane molecule, CH4, and two diatomic oxygen molecules, O2, to produce one carbon dioxide molecule, CO2, and two water molecules, H2O. The chemical equation representing this process is provided in the upper half of figure 4.2, with space-filling molecular models shown in the lower half of the figure. This example illustrates the fundamental aspects of any chemical equation. The substances undergoing reaction are called reactants, and their formulas are placed on the left side of the equation. The substances generated by the reaction are called products, and their formulas are placed on the right side of the equation. Plus signs, plus, separate individual reactant and product formulas, and an arrow, O, separates the reactant and product, left and right, sides of the equation. The relative numbers of reactant and product species are represented by coefficients, numbers placed immediately to the left of each formula. The coefficient of 1 is typically omitted. The chemical equation described in section 4.1 is balanced, meaning that equal numbers of atoms for each element involved in the reaction are represented on the reactant and product sides. This is a requirement the equation must satisfy to be consistent with the law of conservation of matter. It may be confirmed by simply summing the numbers of atoms on either side of the arrow and comparing these sums to ensure they are equal. Note that the number of atoms for a given element is calculated by multiplying the coefficient of any formula containing that element by the element subscript in the formula. If an element appears in more than one formula on a given side of the equation, the number of atoms represented in each must be computed and then added together. For example, both product species in the example reaction, CO2 and H2O, contain the element oxygen, and so the number of oxygen atoms on the product side of the equation is as shown below. The equation for the reaction between methane and oxygen to yield carbon dioxide in water is confirmed to be balanced per this approach, as shown here. The physical states of reactants and products in chemical equations very often are indicated with a parenthetical abbreviation following the formulas. Common abbreviations include S for solids, L for liquids, G for gases, and AC for substances dissolved in water, aqueous solutions, as introduced in the preceding chapter. These notations are illustrated in the example equation here. Given the abundance of water on Earth, it stands to reason that a great many chemical reactions take place in aqueous media. When ions are involved in these reactions, the chemical equations may be written with various levels of detail appropriate to their intended use. To illustrate this, consider a reaction between ionic compounds taking place in an aqueous solution. When aqueous solutions of CaCl2 and AgNO3 are mixed, a reaction takes place producing aqueous CaNO3² and solid alkyl. This balance equation, derived in the usual fashion, is called a molecular equation because it doesn't explicitly represent the ionic species that are present in solution. When ionic compounds dissolve in water, they may dissociate into their constituent ions, which are subsequently dispersed homogeneously throughout the resulting solution. A thorough discussion of this important process is provided in the chapter on solutions. Ionic compounds dissolved in water are, therefore, more realistically represented as dissociated ions, in this case. Unlike these three ionic compounds, alkyl does not dissolve in water to a significant extent, as signified by its physical state notation, solid. Explicitly representing all dissolved ions results in a complete ionic equation. In this particular case, the formulas for the dissolved ionic compounds are replaced by formulas for their dissociated ions. Examining this equation shows that two chemical species are present in identical form on both sides of the arrow, Ca2+, AC, and NO3, AC. These spectator ions, ions whose presence is required to maintain charge neutrality, are neither chemically nor physically changed by the process, and so they may be eliminated from the equation to yield a more succinct representation called a net ionic equation. Following the convention of using the smallest possible integers as coefficients, this equation is then written. This net ionic equation indicates that solid silver chloride may be produced from dissolved chloride and silver ions, regardless of the source of these ions. These molecular and complete ionic equations provide additional information, namely, the ionic compounds used as sources of Cl and Ag+. The chemical reaction is usually written in a way that suggests it proceeds in one direction, the direction in which we read, but all chemical reactions are reversible, and both the forward and reverse reaction occur to one degree or another depending on conditions. In a chemical equilibrium, the forward and reverse reactions occur at equal rates, and the concentrations of products and reactants remain constant. If we run a reaction in a closed system so that the products cannot escape, we often find the reaction does not give a 100% yield of products. Instead, some reactants remain after the concentrations stop changing. At this point, when there is no further change in concentrations of reactants and products, we say the reaction is at equilibrium. A mixture of reactants and products is found at equilibrium. For example, when we place a sample of dinitrogen tetroxide, N2O4, a colorless gas, in a glass tube, it forms nitrogen dioxide, NO2, a brown gas, by the reaction. Factors affecting reaction rate include temperature. If you increase the temperature of reactants, then more product is gained as the forward reaction is favored, vice versa. Now concentration. If you increase concentration of reactants, then the forward reaction is favored so you get more product, vice versa. Pressure applies to reactants or products containing gases. If you increase the pressure of reactant gases, by say decreasing the volume of the reactant system, the forward reaction is favored, vice versa. That is a quick summary on chemical reactions. Thank you for staying tuned in this video. The next video is on quantitative chemistry.